Hello friends, in my YouTube channel all of you are welcome. In the computer network next video lectures I am going to explain the basic definition of computer networks. So you can see that the topics of the network, definition, topology and application, I have already uploaded this video in Hindi in very earlier days. So this video is with due respect of the actually come from the some subscriber. They need to upload, they need to need this video actually in English language. So I am going to make this video, whatever the version is available in Hindi, in the English version is going to be make this video. So in this computer networks, I am going to explain the definition, topology and applications, various applications of computer networks. And if you like this video, then please share and don't forget to subscribe my channel eTeaching Guru, or which is shown in the bottom of this video. So I am going to explain this particular structure is going to be explained, that what is exactly the definition of computer networks and what is the different structure is going to be used as known as a topology, and what are the various kind of application with respect to this topology. So now come to the point. First is called introduction page. Introduction means just define the computer network. So a computer network is a collection of hardware as well as the software that enables a group of computer to communicate and provide user with access to shared resources. Simple definition is given. Computer network is nothing but then collection of hardware as well as operate that hardware, you need a software. So collection of hardware and software, they create a group to communicate to each other, means share their informations. Whatever the information they need, they can share. They can share the file, they can share the message, they can share the even hardware also, just like that printer and different kind of softwares are also be possible. So group of computers is actually known as a computer network. So network means group of computer. So shared resources are the data files can be possible. One example, a spreadsheet is there. So one person's going to be create a spreadsheet, or another example, you can take word processor. So this kind of document is going to be created by one person and see by various other persons in the same group. So that's why one creation and multiple reading. So that is the main purpose of this computer network. Hardware, just like I have already told you that how the hardware means that printer, modem, you can use to access the simple kind of computer network. So what is the exact advantages? You can say that provide total computing facility at each user end, means if you using computer network or you are in computer network, it means not that you have a limitations. You have a full-fledged facilities are there, whatever the computing facilities are there that can be provided to each other, means whatever the PCs are available, they are communicated, they are connected to each other to create the computer network. So nothing specialization is there, nothing other things are there, nothing different kind of PCs are there which are going to be connected. Your simple PC or whatever your laptop is there, they are going to be connected with the local area. So full computing facilities is given. And second one, provide communication facilities among several such users, means one is there, means that your computer having the own computing facilities, as well as whenever the computer is going to be connected to each other, so means they provide the communication facilities. They can send their data, receive their data, just like in WhatsApp. So WhatsApp is nothing but a group of contact numbers. So that's in that same scenario, the computer network is nothing but the group of laptops or hardware devices or PCs are there. Offered access to mass storage system, high speed printers and other service computers, means third point is basically economical point of view. The computer network is making the sense of advantages, means why? If you have a high resolution printer and you have a costlier printer, so each and every person cannot afford that kind of printer. So how the multiple number of person can afford that printer? Just sharing their hardware, means sharing the printer with the computer network. So without this computer network, it is not possible. So that's why the computer network having the major advantages there. Mass storage system means that each and every computer have their own storage power is there. So when they are communicating to each other, they are connected to its computer network. So all this storage unit will be work as a single unit. So they can share their data, they can share their storage also. So mass storage is going to be created by connected with this computer network. High speed printer, I already told, and other services computers are there. So lots of services are there, just like an email services and other kind of services. Without this network, it's not possible. Economical, why? Because I have already told her, because each and every person cannot never be afford a high costlier or high price hardware is there, just like in printer, high resolution printer is not possible to purchase by a single user. So group of users just purchase that printer and share that printer. So that's why it is economically economical, or you can say that economically affordable by a group of people. So because resources are shared by all the user in a LAN, so that's why the advantage, main advantage that is that you can use the hardware, whatever the hardware is there, whatever the information, whatever the storage you have, they can share to each other. So components of the computer is the important parts. If you tell about that computer networks, means you need some kind of specific components which is actually used to create the computer, computer networks. So components are there. So you can see that here's the different components are there. You have seen that sender is there, receiver is there. Between sender to receiver, a media is there. Media means by using how the data is going from one end to another, it means from sender to receiver ends. So and next one is called, you have a message is there, it's also the components parts. You have a protocols is there, you have a protocols in the receiving ends, means protocols and how the data, in which conditions or which guidelines they can send from one end to another. So that's why this is known as a protocol. So let's start with the different components: sender, message, medium, protocols and receivers. So senders and receivers are the same aspect. Message means what kind of information you are going you wish to send, and media means how the media is there. So that is a wired media or wireless media. So media can be it can be a wired or it can be a wireless. Nowadays wireless is maximum use. Protocol means under the guidelines, whatever the guidelines is there to send the data from the sender send to the receiving end via this media. So now come to the point, some definitions are there. What is protocols? A protocol is a set of rules that govern data communications. Means I have already told you, the protocol is nothing but that, a set of rules, a set of guidelines. In other words, the protocol defined as a what is communicated, means syntax, what kind of syntax they basically used or they actually used under the criteria of this protocol. So whatever the protocols is there, so they have to be followed, means message will be created according to that particular. So what is communicated, that's the main point. Second is how it is communicated, means semantic, means how the message is going to be communicated. That means meaning will be there, semantics is there. So when it is communicated, when it is communicated means which time they are initiated to send the data, means each and every time they cannot send the data. When the receiver end and the sender's end is going to be ready, then you can send the data. That is the time. So when the communication, that is timing. So three important things are there. Now come to the point, standard. There is a two type of standards are there. So standards are essentially in creating and maintaining a open and competitive market for equipment manufacturer, and is guaranteeing national and international interoperability of data and the telecommunication technology and process. So basically standard means if you define a standard, so worldwide they can create the same configuration based hardware and as well as software. So you need a standard. So this standard is actually the essential part to creating and maintaining the hardware as well as software which is required in computer network. Standard categories are two type of standards are there. De facto standards. De facto means that standards that have not been approved by an organization body. De facto means by default some kind of nickname is going to be started and they can be used. So this type of standard is not defined by any kind of organization or any kind of professional bodies. Or de jure standards means that standard that have been legislated by a official recognized body, means that is have a standard means those type of standard which is actually defined or approved by some governing bodies or some official recognized body. So there are the two different type of de facto means by default you can use some kind of rules and regulation and use it for the worldwide, and same as de jure means according to the rules and regulation, according to the some standard means according to some approved by some organization body or organizational body or officially standard internationally recognized body is going to be approved. So that is known as a de jure standards. Standard organizations. This is ISO, first is standard organization, means de jure standards means if you use the protocol under the category of the de jure, so some kind of standard organizations are there. First is called ISO, International Standard Organization. Second one is called ITUT, International Telecommunication Union, telecommunication. So that is basically used for cable purpose. ANSI, American National Standard Institute. Next standard organization is IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Next one is the EIA, Electronic Industrial Association. These are the some standard organizations, means standard means well-defined organizations are there. They approved some kind of protocols, means all the different type of protocols which is under the category of de jure. Now come to the one important aspect of the computer networks, means when the group of network computer is going to be create or when the group of computers are joined to each other or and send share their information and send the or communicating to each other, so they are called computer network. Then the important part is that if you say that the computer network means that collections of or group of computer, they are connected to each other, means how the connection will be performed, how the structure, how the different kind of graphs can be possible to create a group of computer or connected this group of computer. So that's why topology is actually defined that. So the geometric representation of relationship of all the links and the linked device usually called a nodes to one another. Nodes means nothing but the computer. You can consider as a computer, computer, or in the sense of generalizations, so you can consider as a nodes. Node can be a laptop, can be a mobile, can be a computer, can be any devices. In the today's scenario, IoT is basically used for this nodes. So node means anything can be, but any hardware can be possible. So when the nodes are connected to each other, how the which kind of geometrical patterns actually used to connect them? So this is known as a topology. So we have a four basic topologies are there, and based on that next topology is that called fifth number topology is known as a hybrid topology, the combination of this four. The first topology is called mesh topology, star topology, bus topology and ring topology. Then let's start with the mesh topology. Mesh topology look like this one, so means each computer are connected to each other, means every computer connected to each other. You can see that in between every computer there is a single connection is there. So one computer have a multiple connection with the multiple senders, or you can say that multiple computers. So not common on LAN. Basically this type of topology is not regularly used or not recommended, not common for on LAN. So basically LAN is not used, most often used for WAN to interconnected LANs, means when you are going to create a wide area network by using the local area network, this mesh topology is beneficial. Each node is connected to every other node, means I have already told you that what is the basic characteristics of mesh topology, means each and every node connected to other nodes. allow communication to continue in the event of a break in any one connections. Means that this is the basic advantages is there. If any connection is lost between two computers, so that computer is never lost their connection with the other. They can communicate to the other computer. So break is normal. Means tolerance is high tolerance. If fault tolerant, and it is fault tolerant. Fault tolerant means if I have already told you that in the fourth point. So the fourth point actually defined as if it is fault tolerant means if any connection is lost, other connection is going to be resumed. So advantages is improve fault tolerance. Improve fault tolerance means if any connection is lost, remaining connections are there. So you can correct that particular connection and start the communication again. Disadvantages in the disadvantages, the first point is expensive. Why? Because you need a huge number of wires to connect to each other. Difficult to install means you have to be careful about that each and every computer to connect it to each other in a single way. In a single means once a single connection will there, they never be cross connected. So this is called an installation problems, or any kind of fault is there. So how to detect the fault? It is again a difficult task that is described in the third point. Difficult to manage, that is the main point, and difficult to troubleshoot. Next point is same as the manage and the troubleshoot are they are similar to each other. So you can say that the difficult to troubleshoot means if any kind of connection loss is there, so you have to be checked each and every connections, means every wire, to carefully check that which wire actually not going to be communicated to other systems. So that is the complex task is there. So that's why it is a difficult to troubleshoot. Star topology, come to the point. Star topology is just like that. A central hub is there and other computers are connected to that particular hub. So you can see that very basic things are there. If hub is lost, so all the particular computer network is going to be collapsed. So like the spoke of a wheel without the symmetrics, means just you can consider this topology as a spoke of a wheel, means cycle wheel. You can see, you have seen that. So that kind of consideration can be possible here. Center point is a hub. Segment meet at the hub, means all the computer are connected to this hub. Each device need its own cable to hub, means each and every device is connected to this hub. They are not never connected to each other. Systems are connected to only the hub. They are not connected to each other. Predominant type of topology, and easy to maintain and expand. Easy to maintain and expand means that if you want to increase your network, so when you can connect one another PC to this hub, if the hub having their own number of ports, having the ports, so you can communicate, you can connect it with this hub. So it's an easy installation process is there, and easy to maintain also, or you can expand also. But mesh topology, if you want to expand one, means if you want to add one more device in the net computer in the network or mesh topology, so you have to be create multiple number of cables. So you have to be connected all the systems with that different cables are there. So based on that, that is not possible, easy, not easily possible to expand it. Star topology advantages: easy to add device at the network expanded. One cable failure does not bring down the entire network. The advantage is there, means if one cable is failed from the hub, so that will be other devices are connected or communicated to each other. Hub provides centralized management, easy to find device and cable problems. Whatever the problems exist in the mesh topology, that is resolved here. Means easy to find out that which cable having the problems, and you can solve it. Can be upgraded to faster speed and lots of support as it is most used. So this type of star topology is maximally used for local area networks. So disadvantages: a star network require more cable than a ring or bus. So it is better than the mesh topology, but as compared to the ring and bus topology, it is less. It is having a disadvantages. Failure of the central hub can bring down. I have already told that if the that is the main disadvantages, that if the hub is collapsed, then whole the network is going to be collapsed. Costs are higher installation and equipment than for most bus networks, means it is costlier than the bus topology, but less costlier than the mesh topology. Bus topology, now come to the point, next type of topology is there. This is the bus topology. You can see that one single cable is there and multiple drop points to connect the device or connect the computer with this cable. So you can see that when the computer means drop line is connected with this cable, you can see that this rail red cable actually known as a bus. So this is having a 2K end point, cable end point is there, and the tap is used to connect with this particular drop line of the device with this particular bus means main cable. So now come to the point, what is the description? Is the standard means bus topology is actually under the category of one standard, that is called IEEE standard 802.3. it is in standard topology. Network maintained by a single cable and cable segment must end with a terminator. I have told you that the red cables, actually the single cable is there and they have their end portion, terminator point. Use thin coaxial cable, backbones will be thick coaxial cables. Two types of coaxial cable, coaxial cables are there. So that is actually used for bus topology. Extra station can be added in a daisy chain manner, means if you want to add some extra computers or device, you can add it. So bus to, in the continuation, bus topology, because it's follow the some standards, IEEE 802.3 standards. So based on the standard, some kind of cables are actually used, standard cables. The thin Ethernet, that is also known as a 10 base 2, has a maximum segment length of 20 meters, means if you use this standard cable, so that can stretch up to the longest, or you can say that maximum length of this cable can be possible 200 meter. Maximum number of connection up to this 200 meter cable, 30 devices can be connected. 4 repeaters may be used to total length to increase 1000, means 1000 can be possible by using some repeater. After 200 meters, you just put a repeater and connect the another 200 meter length cable. So up to that 1000 meter can be possible. Maximum number of node is 150, means if you use 5 times cable, 4 repeaters, so that is multiply, if you multiply 30 into 5, means 150 devices can be possible up to 1000 length, means maximum 200 cable is there, but if you want to extend it, you need a repeaters. Thick Ethernet is used, it is known as a 10 base 5, used for backbones, means limited up to 500 meter. Whatever the Ethernet 10 base 2 use the length of 200 meter, instead of that it having the length of 500 meter, maximum of 100 nodes per segment can be possible, and total 4 repeaters and 2500 meters with a total of 488 node can be possible. So now come to the point, bus topology advantages: inexpensive to install, very easy to install it, easy to add stations, use less cable than other topology. Definitely it's correct, because mesh topology, star topology, the length of the cable is much more higher than this bus topology. So less cable is there. Works well for small networks. It's not works for the larger networks or bigger networks. The star topology is work for the bigger network. Disadvantages: no longer recommended, because it is basically nowadays is not used, so no longer recommended. Recommendation is not there, so basically use the star topology or ring topology in nowadays local area networks. So backbone breaks whole networks down, means if the main cable is not work properly, then whole the networks is going to be down. So limited number of devices can be attached, means you cannot attach multiple number of devices, means unlimited devices never be there. You have a limitation. Difficult to isolate problems. So if any kind of drop cables or any kind of device have a problem, so you have a difficulty to find out that particular, means debugging of the particular or you consider a particular faulty devices, it is difficult, quite difficult than the star topology. Sharing same cable, slow response rates. You can understand that very well. Now come to the one ring topology. Ring topology just like look like that means each cable means each one computer is connected to another, another is to connected to another. So this kind of ring facility means if you see that carefully, so a ring is going to be created. No beginning or end means in that ring topology you never find out that which one is begin start PC or start device and which is that end device. All devices of equally of access to media, all device have their own, all device have the same priority to access the cable, whatever the cable provided in a ring topology. Single ring, data travels in one direction only. Guess what a double ring allows. So in a single rings, only one direction, either it can be a clockwise or it can be a anti-clockwise directions. So one directional use by using this single ring data means the data travel in only one direction. Same as you can guess that if having a two ring is there, then what will be the possibilities there. Means if have a two rings, so I can say that if one ring is fail, then another ring is automatically work. Each device has to wait its turn to transmit. Means that whatever the device means, how many devices are connected to this ring topology, each and every device have their same type of priorities. Means they can send the data in the same manner or same priority. So each device has to wait to turn to transmit. Means if one device is going to be transmit some data, so other devices definitely wait for that. So each device has to be wait to transmit the data. So most common type is token ring. This is standard is there. Another type of standard is there. So basically if you say that the ring topology, so this is called a simple de facto standard ring. But if you maintain the some standard, means IEEE 802 standards, it is known as the token ring standards. Means if any, means this ring topology is nothing but the standard of token ring or standard of IEEE 802.5, also named as a token ring. A token contains the data reaches the destination, data extracted, acknowledgement of receipt sent back to the transmission device, remove empty token passed on to another device. Means in a token means token ring topology means I'm going to explain the IEEE 802.5. So little explanation is there. So in a token ring type of ring topology, so token is basically used. So a token is free token is moving in this ring. So if any device have their data, so they capture the token and then add the data or add the message or information to the token, and that token is along with the message reaches to the destination, and in the destination data is going to be extracted. You can see that, and the destination acknowledge that the data has been received successfully and sent back to the, means with acknowledgement sent back to the transmitter device, and that is detected that means that data is successfully received. Then it's free the token, means removed it, means whatever the message is there, that is removed from the token, and empty token passed on the another device too. Means that empty token is released to the ring, and that ring means that token is again moving in the ring freely, and if any kind of device is having their own data, that will be captured again and do the same process. Now come to the ring topology advantages. Data packet travel at a great speed, no collision, means it is unidirectional, it's not a bidirectional communication, so never be never possible to collide any kind of data. Easier to fault find, you can easily find, no terminal requires. So easy to fault find, easier to fault find means, in one question I am going to arise along among with you, how you can say that easier to fault find. So you just send me the answer in my email or in the message. So I'm going to find out that your answer is proper or not. So disadvantages there. Requires more cables than a bus. A break in the ring will bring it down. Means that is the fault. If one cable between two devices there, so whole ring topology or whole network is going to be collapsed. Not as common as the bus, less devices available. So it's not common as the bus, means common as bus, less devices. You can say that it is the disadvantage is that. Hybrid topology, nothing but the combinations of all the kind of basic topology. So you can see that this is an this is a ring topology is there, this is star topology is there, as well as a bus topology. So you can see that in the center parts ring topology is there, in the top part star topology is there, in the bottom part that is one kind that is a bus topology. So old networks are updated and replaced, leaving older segments. Hybrid topology combines two or more different physical topologies, whatever the topologies are there. So commonly star or ring topologies are used to create a hybrid topologies. Star ring use a MU, multi station access unit. So friends, if you like this video and understand the concept of topology or as well as the different the basic definitions of computer networks, so please like this video, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is shown in the bottom, e-teaching Gurukul. So, and as well as if you have some kind of questions or queries or have some kind of comments, you can definitely comments to this particular video. So my dear friends, at the last you have seen this particular video, I am going to thank you.